Hello and welcome to this entry of the nail journal. Today I'm going to be showing you a few ways that I've been able to get straight lines as a nail art beginner and more recently as someone with super shaky hands. So I'm starting off with a regular nail tip and I've got a few brushes here. I'll only be using two of them. I'll be using a shorter one just as an example and one long one just to show you how that's a bit of a better option if you've got shaky hands. So I'm just painting this tip in a regular black polish and I'm going to cure it for 60 seconds and then do a second coat and then cure it for 60 seconds again. And then I will apply a matte top coat and we can get started. So whilst I get it set up, just a quick background. I've been a self-taught nail artist for the last 2 years. I wouldn't really consider myself a beginner anymore. However, I do have very shaky hands. I experience hand tremors pretty regularly. And so documenting this is really important to me just because I can see how far I've come, how far along I've come, and also just might be helpful to somebody starting out who also has super shaky hands. So now that I've got the matte top coat on, I'm using I believe it's a 9mm, it's either 9 or 10mm brush. So about a year ago, I wouldn't have been able to do this. My line would have been all over the shop, but I've attended a few workshops and I've just had lots of practice. So it's a little bit easier, but as you can see, when I'm showing an example of me shaking my hand, it's really hard to achieve a straight line with a brush that length for me personally. So now I'm going in with one that I think is between 11 and 13 millimeters. So I'm gonna leave links to all the products I use in the description, but going in with a much longer brush has honestly been a life-changing, a lifesaver. So as you can see, that first line was super easy. So somebody explained this, and I'm terrible because I can't remember how they did, but it's something to do with the amount of space between the brush and where your hand is placed allows, I think it's also something to do with gravity possibly, but it just allows for a lot more control. So I have naturally shaky hands and I will exaggerate from time to time and sometimes I won't, but they're relatively shaky and so I struggle to get straight lines sometimes, and so using a longer brush like this is super helpful. Now this line was proving tricky because of the way I applied the matte top coat. It cured a little, like, what's the word, creased just at the sidewall there, and so that's why I was struggling to get that straight line. As you can see, the other lines that I've done on the nail are a lot straighter. So yeah, I'm just gonna keep at it and stop talking so you can see how much more helpful this brush is. So I'm just picking up that shorter brush again, just to show a way that you can remedy a shaky line if you're using a shorter brush. Because this is a pretty standard length of a brush that you can buy online. If you went on Amazon and searched for, you know, like a super fine liner, this Bquan, I think it's pronounced, a brush will come up pretty often. So I find just going back in and adding a bit more thickness helps. But of course, if you're using the longer brush, you can just put more pressure on the brush and still achieve that kind of thickness if that's what you want. So now I'm just randomly deciding to show you how I would normally use this length. So doing things like swirls and squiggly lines and filling in and outlining stuff is how I would usually use a brush of this length. Otherwise, I would go in with a longer brush. I am going to pick up the longer brush now and show you that if I was to try and achieve the same squiggly lines, it's a lot harder. It requires a lot more muscle just because it's weird. The lack of control that you have for things like swirls is actually really helpful when it comes to trying to get those lines. So now I'm going in and putting a lot less pressure on the brush and achieving a super fine line. So that's another thing that I mentioned just before, that you can achieve various thicknesses depending on what pressure you put on the brush. But yeah, this is how I get my straight lines. I use a super extra long brush, and then I use the shorter one for things like squigglies and outlining. Just want to jump in here and say that obviously all of these lines are super angled, and it's because of the way I was filming, less so because of the brush. They would have been a lot less angled had I just been, you know, painting as normal. So now I'm just showing you the two brushes for reference on the difference in length. Like I said, I will link everything below. This is another one that I like to use, which is just slightly longer than the one that I was using before. But yeah, I'll have all of the links and the measurements and things in the description. Next up, we have spider gel. So I think even before I realized I could get better lines with an extra long brush, this is one of the first ways I would get straight lines in my nail art. So if I was doing a checkered design or anything like that, this is what I used. And I kind of stumbled upon it when I first got the spider gel and I was just kind of trying to figure out how to use it. I was like, oh my goodness, I can get really straight lines with this. This is how I'm gonna do it. And I do like this technique. It's just, it can be quite messy. You'll see as I go along that like when you bring the spider gel back after getting your first line, you then have to like cut the gel off, and it can go everywhere. I mean, you can see it's all over the lid. Yeah, it's quite messy, but you can get some really nice straight lines. I think I knocked my hand at this point, which is why this one went a bit wonky, but yeah, I mean, look at how nice and easy that is. Besides the mess, it's a pretty like surefire way to get some nice straight lines in there, even if you have shaky hands, or even if you're a beginner. I'd actually say about 10 minutes of playing around with this and you'll get a good hang of it. And depending on what brand you're using, some are less messy than others, but this particular one from Born Pretty is quite messy. So like I said, I will shut up and just show you the different ways in which I achieve straight lines using the spider gel. Also, just want to quickly jump in and say that if you're doing lines that are separate to each other, like I'm doing here, it's fine to just do them all at once. However, if you intend to overlap the lines, like if you're doing a checkered design, or, you know, like a kind of like a Burberry design, I would highly recommend curing as you do each line, maybe using like a UV torch or something. Otherwise, they won't come out as neat. You may also notice that this has a matte base and then this next nail doesn't. So with the spider gel, I'd recommend using a matte base just because the gel is less likely to move and spread around. For this one, a shiny base is fine. And this is actually a tip that I painted a while ago and was just kind of sitting there. So I've just applied some primer just so it's sticky because we're going to be doing some stamping. So my last my last and favorite tip has to be stamping. So I'm just showing you a couple of plates here that I use for different types of line work. There are some designs that I've actually posted on my feed using both of these plates. So the one I'm going to be using is from Pictou, and another one that I use regularly is this one from Moyu. I hope I'm pronouncing those things correctly. So I'm just going to go in with this Born Pretty stamping gel in white, Born Pretty scraper, and a Born Pretty jelly stamper. I actually didn't realize I had so much Born Pretty stuff, but yeah, here we go. So yeah, I'm just applying the polish as you normally would, and then I'm gonna scrape, and then yeah, get into it. I'm actually gonna shut up for this one so you can just watch how I do it. So in that first initial stamp, I just showed you how you can just use all the lines that were picked up in that first section of the plate. But this time I'm gonna be creating a fuller look using another section of the plate. And this really demonstrates why this is one of my favorite techniques for getting straight lines if you're a beginner or if you have shaky hands, because you can create a really nice full look using like an eighth of this particular plate. There are lots of different ways that you can achieve straight lines using stamping too, so it really does just give you a lot more options designs wise. Plus it's a lot less mess, so you know, sign me up. Anyway, I think that is everything for this video. I hope you enjoyed this. I hope you enjoyed this nice reflection of my face in the plate. If you did enjoy it, then please feel free to like and subscribe if you would like to. And yeah, I will see you in my next video. Bye-bye.